Alec Baldwin and his wife Hilaria have a beautiful estate in East Hampton, New York, which they call home. Alec purchased the 18th century farmhouse back in 1995, and these days, the refurbished abode has plenty of space for the couple's 6 kids to play in. Aside from this spread, Alec owns a duplex penthouse in Greenwich Village, which spans over 4,000 square feet, and today we're gonna check out his properties. In these videos, we don't reveal any addresses, and even though I've done a house tour of my own place, please do not show up at any private residences because it's not safe for anyone. Alec Baldwin is an actor, comedian, film producer, and more, as well as the eldest of the 4 brothers in the Baldwin family. At the time of this recording, his estimated net worth is at about $60 million or more. Mr. Baldwin purchased his multi-acre estate in East Hampton way back in the 90s when he was with his ex, Kim Basinger, for a total of $1.8 million. And now, the stunning property is valued at well over $5 million. Alec's current wife, Hilaria, moved in when they began dating in 2011, and they completely renovated and updated the shingle-style farmhouse at the same time. Hey guys, it's Kara the Vampire Slayer back with another exclusive house tour here on Famous Entertainment. This one looking at where Alec Baldwin calls home. Be sure to subscribe and ring that bell for notifications because we post brand new videos daily. As always, you can follow me over on Instagram to chat, and now let's get into this video. Before we look at his current homes, back in 2015, Alec sold one of his real estate holdings in New York City, a modest condo which spanned 840 square feet and boasted 1 bed and 1 bath. This was only one of 3 apartments he and Hilaria owned at the fancy Devonshire House building in the neighborhood of Greenwich Village, Manhattan. Alec purchased this 8th floor unit back in 2013 for $2.25 million, and it ended up selling at a slight loss for $2.1 million, which didn't even consider the improvements and upkeeps during that time. The quaint apartment was rarely used by Alec, and finished interiors included oak floors and solid core doors. The galley-style kitchen was small, but packed in top-of-the-line appliances, glam fixtures, and even a snug dining area. The bathroom was tucked away off a small hallway which connected the living room to the single bedroom. That bathroom had radiant heated marble floors, as well as marble countertops to match, while the bedroom packed a small city view window and additional space for a desk. Since Alec rarely, if ever, used that apartment, he continues to own a much more spacious and bougie duplex penthouse in the same Manhattan building, the Devonshire House. He and his family used to live here most of the time before they made the Hamptons estate their main residence. This one-of-a-kind duplex spans the 12th and penthouse floors of the pre-war condo conversion building, and Alec snagged it for $12.5 million back in 2011. Located in the hip Greenwich Village, the apartment itself was styled by Studio B, an environmentally friendly design and build team, and boasts 4,137 square feet of space with 4 beds and 4.5 baths throughout. Not to mention, word is that Hilaria grabbed the neighboring 1-bed-and-1-bath unit in 2012 for $1.2 million, so who knows, they could have possibly even combined them. The Devonshire House is an Emery Roth designed building dating back to 1920, and amenities here include a landscaped rooftop terrace, a fitness center, children's playroom, and more. Alec's duplex penthouse had posh interior spaces when he purchased it, and each of the bedrooms have their own private bathroom with window. Of course, those interiors were redone since Alec and Hilaria moved in, and the space included a large dining room, 2 master suites, a cozy fireplace, and a den on the upper floor. The main master bedroom was tucked into the corner with stellar views and boasted an entryway with coat closet, while the ensuite bath had a glass shower and separate soaking tub. Other add-ons here include a private lounge area and study, and a dressing hall lined with closets. Talk about a luxury master suite. Elsewhere in the penthouse, the main living area surrounds a floating staircase and includes a living room with fireplace, dining room, as well as an eat-in kitchen, boasting an island with snack bar, white cabinets and counters, as well as a farmhouse sink and commercial stainless steel appliances. Looking at the floor plan, things seem to be arranged awkwardly in certain areas of the home, but only because one has to go through the kitchen or dining room to get to the living room. I guess that's not really a deal breaker though. Second floor features in Alex's duplex include a family room or den with a built-in wet bar, as well as a bathroom, and access to two terraces. The outdoor spaces include a smaller terrace that overlooks the building courtyard, while the bigger one floats above East 10th Street. As of 2020, it seems Alec had been trying to sell this penthouse off-market, since the actor and his family had been living in the Hamptons since the pandemic. However, no news of its selling has been heard of since last year. For Alec, East Hampton has been home since 1982 when he began renting vacation properties in the area, and he still prefers it here over Manhattan. The actor and his wife spent most of their summers in the Hamptons before moving there full-time, which seems to be a good decision as the large home has room for the couple and all six of their children. Alec purchased this 18th century farmhouse back in 1995 when he was with his ex-wife, which is a multi-acre estate made up of a couple of neighboring properties. While the actor spent a total of $1.8 million back then, these days, his impressive property is valued at well over $5 million. Hilaria moved in after the pair started dating in 2011, and then they gutted and renovated the shingle-style abode to transform it into a bright, modern family home while keeping classic touches. The home was built back in 1753 with a salt box design, including a long pitched roof, which slopes to the back, and then it was converted into a full two-level home in the 1790s. Local historians also said a team of oxen moved the house to its current location, and then around 1913, an architect remodeled the home once again. We can see glimpses of the home's interior now that it's been modernized by the Baldwins, and it's fresh but still cozy as ever. As soon as you step inside, there's a beautiful large staircase leading to both the top and lower floors, while the main rooms surround it. The media room or living room boasts natural light, a fireplace, and wood-paneled walls that are original to the house. There are also elegant wing-back chairs here for family movie nights. The open kitchen has dark hardwood flooring complemented by white cabinets and counters. There's snack bar style seating, a large island, stainless steel appliances, and the kitchen opens to the dining room where the large family usually eats dinner together. Alec's wife Hilaria has said that before the renovation, the house was made up of many small rooms, so they open the common spaces up for more flow. The dining room has French doors to outside, another fireplace, and a wooden dining table from Fisher's at Sag Harbor. A light-filled room located off of the living room was dubbed the Wine Banquet by the Baldwins, and it's the perfect space to entertain family and friends. The hallway outside of Alec and Hilaria's master suite is the perfect example of the home's classic farmhouse meets modern style, with the reclaimed barn door and a glamorous selenite chandelier overhead. The couple's master bedroom itself is super spacious, with a fireplace as well as French doors to a private balcony. There's a plush bed as you might expect, as well as custom blue velvet club chairs. The bright ensuite bath has the color scheme to match with Spanish-inspired blue and white tile, as well as a bubble chandelier, glass shower, and separate tub. We've even seen Hilaria, who's a yoga instructor, do some of her moves in the spacious bathroom before she goes to bed every night. The children's bedrooms each have their own sense of style. For instance, their daughter Carmen has lavender carpet, walls, and furnishings in her room, while their son Raphael has a room with more neutral colors and a bunch of stuffed animals. Elsewhere in the Hamptons abode, Hilaria has a home office as well. The beachfront property comes in handy for the family to enjoy time outdoors, and the kids often go outside to play in the sand. The grounds of Alec's home also offer a picture-perfect walkway to lead around the property, and elsewhere there's a cozy hammock to unwind. As you might expect, the mansion even boasts a large swimming pool, which is perfect for the summertime. Alright guys, that's all I got for the homes of Alec Baldwin and his massive family. What did you guys think about his New York properties? Are you more into the Manhattan penthouse living or the beachfront mansion in the Hamptons? That's an easy pick for me. I would take the Hamptons home for sure. It has so much character and history, not to mention plenty of space both inside and outside away from the busy city. Be sure to let me know what you liked or didn't like about Alec's homes in the comments down below. I'll be waiting to hear from you guys. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to follow me on Instagram, and I will see you all next time. Bye!